Abu Bakr was not elected by people to be the Khalifa, so to speak, the Khalifa, the successor to Rasulullah. Abu Bakr was just forced onto people, the Ansar, the dwellers of Al-Madinah, by Umar. That's why 2 years and a half later, when Abu Bakr died, before his death, what did Abu Bakr do? He transferred the leadership to Umar. You scratch my back, I scratch your back. People hated that. They did not want Umar to be the leader. They wanted it to be a vote and all that kind of stuff, right? But it didn't happen. It's Abu Bakr who gave it to Umar. And all those things, our scholars, I don't know how these people are scholars, subhanAllah. They completely ignored the Islam and took these historical things and built upon them an Islam. This is why for the Muslim countries, anyone who gets to power, he never moves from there, because he's got enough ahadith to eternalize them as a president or king or what have you. Okay, so if anyone criticized Abu Bakr, guess what? They're gonna start by telling you he was with Rasulullah when he migrated. The Quran doesn't say that. The person that was with the Messenger of Allah when the Messenger migrated was not a Muslim. He was not a believer. It's the Quran never said it's Abu Bakr. It's the books of history. So they start with Abu Bakr and how much he spent and how much he did it and how much he did that. And he was the most favorite companions of Rasulullah. And all these are political text to control our mind, so that when you say, why is he the leader? They say, oh, look at all the list of all the goodies of this man. And there you are. You are against that. And on top of that, Abu Bakr is given the goodness of being of the dwellers of paradise, which is a lie, of course. And then they get to Umar. And Umar, one of his characteristics, or the biggest of them all, really, in my sight, is what's mentioned in the books, authentic books of Bukhari and so on and so forth, that Ash-Shaytan is scared of Umar. Subhanallah, this is incredible how the Muslim mind is so childlike mind. It just accepts everything and never questions. My brothers and my sisters, do you know, by accepting that Ash-Shaytan is scared of Umar, we are making Umar better than our father Adam. Adam was tricked by Ash-Shaytan. Adam was less intelligent than the Shaytan, and the Shaytan swooped Adam out of Jannah. But in our Islam, this man-made Islam, well, guess what? A Shaytan is scared about Umar. Subhanallah. If Allah was going to make somebody, a Shaytan get scared of somebody, that should have been Adam, not Umar. And as such, Umar is far better than Adam, which is absolutely nonsense. A Shaytan is scared of nobody. From messengers to humans, Ash-Shaytan is actively working to get the majority of us into hell fire. And of course, if Allah didn't close the line of prophets, Umar would have been the next in line. And they will tell you this hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. Who told the messenger this nonsense? I want to ask a question, yeah? Was it Allah that told the messenger that if Muhammad was not the last of messengers, Allah would have chosen Umar? If so, what's the purpose? Why did Allah do that? And the reason behind this, why? And if it wasn't Allah who told the messenger, how did he receive that kind of information from other than Allah? You see, this is absolutely mind-controlling thing. Umar ibn al-Khattab, at the time of his friends, the companions, Umar ibn al-Khattab, great, huge number of the companions didn't like him. They actually thought he was a dictator. Umar ibn al-Khattab, in our times, with the international way of looking at things now and the intelligence that Allah has given us, Umar ibn al-Khattab is nothing else but a dictator that used to have a stick in his hand. He used to beat up on people, men or young people. He was an extremely violent person. Always you hear that Umar wants to cut the head of this and the messenger tells him not. He is more man than the messenger. Subhanallah, this is extremely stupid. But nobody, as I said, we have a childlike brain. Okay, so Umar, the dictator that he is a good justification for any ruler in the Muslim world to do as he pleases, and the scholars will just bow at this ruler. Why? Because Umar did that, and the scholars did that, and the companions did and did that. So in conclusion, my dear sisters and my brothers, no one, and I will say it, absolutely no one knows where their abode shall be. Even the messenger himself, he doesn't know what's going to be done to him, and he doesn't know what's going to be done to his followers. If our messenger didn't know where he is going to go, either to paradise or hellfire, and were it not that Allah forgave him his sins, the messenger would have been in very hot waters. That's why Allah forgave his sins. And in Al-Quran, the messenger has done a lot of wrong, and Allah corrected it countless times. And I will do a talk, inshallah, one day about the messenger in the Quran and the messenger out of the Quran, and you will find out that there are two different people altogether. So again, absolutely no one knows where Abu Bakr is going to end up. I think all the 10 people that have been given the good news of paradise, none of them is going to paradise, and there was no way for the messenger to know that. And the whole thing is for more political reasons and agendas. Abu Bakr and Omar and all these people are mortals that died, and on Judgment Day, Allah will hold them accountable to their acts. And believe it or not, a huge number of companions will end up in hell fire. Don't worry, a small tiny minority of them will go to paradise, but a huge majority of them will go to hell fire. And this is in Al-Quran. This is again what Allah says in Al-Quran. And the lie against Allah and His messenger must stop. The lie is what is in the hadith. We must go back to the Quran. So one more time, Abu Bakr is not of the dwellers of paradise, and neither is Umar, and neither is even the messengers. Allah will decide on Judgment Day. Again, this is your brother Abdus Salam, and until my next talk, inshallah, remain in the mercy of Allah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.